Now I want to talk about Candlelight. I love makeup because I can do so many different types of things with it, and so can you. One of my favorite things to do is to take light and shadow and manipulate that in some way. Now, there are contouring ways to use the shadow part, but now I want to talk about the light part. And the light comes in several different forms. You can have it in a stick form like this one by Nars Copacabana. You can have it in a high beam, which is like a pearlescent cream. This is by Benefit. It comes in a cream compact like this one from Jemma Kid. This is called Dewy Glow. It's an all-over radiance cream. Or you can simply just use an eyeshadow that has shimmer in it that's more of a pearl essence. So if you see it that way, it's just kind of a pearl color. Anyway, how you use it is this. If you just look at the contours of my hand and I put this on top of it, it just makes it pop. So you can make areas of your face pop. That reflects the light back out. Now, you don't want it to be a glitter. You don't want it to be a strong paillette or anything. You just want it to be more of a glow. And that's what I mean by the candlelight. You can use it. Maybe this one will show it a little bit more. Just makes it pop out like that. If you can see that. Now, these colors happen to be in the pinky sort of silvery family. So if you have dark skin, I would stay away from that and kind of veer more towards the golds. And they have other products that have more champagne or gold colors. And that's wonderful as well. Light skin colors can do both. They're still beautiful either way. But how you would use them on your face is really what I want to talk about now. You would take a little bit of this and you would put it just at the top of your cheekbone to make it pop. Also can bring it around on top, just slightly on top of your brow to define it. A lot of people like to put it underneath the brow. That's the old school way of just highlighting the brow with a lighter color. Some people put white there, but that's kind of very 90s now. If you blend it in more with this kind of champagne color, and I'll show you on this side as well, how it just pops like that. But you don't want to make it too much of a pearl there because otherwise it just jumps back at you if you're going to be on film. And brides should take note that this is a really great way of putting the light in your face when you can't control the environment around you. People are taking pictures from all angles. You go from day to evening. So if you're managing how you put light on your face or how you put the candlelight, then you're in much better control. Another place to put it is straight down your nose, especially if you want to contour your nose. See it that way? You can put a little bit right here on your cheek. Very slight. You don't need to keep adding product. You still have whatever is on your hand. And that makes your cheek have a nice dewy glow. Another place that I love, love, love to do this is just here on your Cupid's bow. You see how that just makes your lips pop? What's great about that is it makes you look like you have fuller lips, even if you don't, or you have really defined lips. So it's a beautiful place to put it. Last but not least, it's really nice to put it on your collarbone. You can use several fingers for that. If you're wearing something low cut, I'll show you with the Jemma Kid one. Just rub it right in. You really can't go wrong, as long as you don't see fingerprints, because that's sometimes what people do. But I hope you enjoyed that. Now you can control light and shadow.